Let's continue our exploration about Windows, preparing Windows 6.5 release. Today, we will set up Windows 10 VM in Azure so we can know the difference between Windows 6.5 and Windows 10 VM in Azure. What's the difference of it?
Same, same, but different, but still same.
Before that, don't forget to subscribe so you will get notification for each new video in the channel. Okay, let's start it. Let's start by open Azure portal. To create Windows 10 virtual machine, we choose virtual machine and then create virtual machine. Okay, let's expand it. Yeah. First, for resource group, we create or select the existing one. For virtual machine name, just say we name it Windows 10. For region, choose the one that's nearest to you, and since I'm from Indonesia, I will choose Southeast Asia. For availability option, choose the first one since this one is the cheapest one. For the image, let's expand it by click see all image. Yeah, and then we search Windows 10. Okay. Click this select, and there is a very diverse option here, but I suggest you choose the Windows 10 Enterprise, the latest one, 21H1 Gen 2. Also, if you notice, there's Gen 1 and Gen 2. Just choose the Gen 2, since the newer Azure VM will have several new features in Azure. For size, let's expand see all size. As for today, Windows 6.5 was only shown VM with 2 vCPU and 4GB memory. Let's filter it with the same option. So with vCPU 2 and 4GB memory. Let's choose B2S since it was cheaper. Next, enter administrator username and password. Just say username is Sagi. Password. For inbound port rules, just select RDP since we will not connect to other service. Assuming you have Windows 10 license, just check on the licensing and then next. For OS this type, assuming that Windows 6.5 is using an SSD, let's choose the same one. Select the standard SSD, yeah, because the premium is more expensive, yeah. And then let's just click review and create so we can get the preview pricing for this virtual machine, yeah. Okay. Now the control panel is showing the preview price for this virtual machine. It shows Indonesian rupiah since my tenant is located in Indonesia. Yeah, even when the data center is not in Indonesia. Okay, let's convert it to US dollar to give you a better perspective. If 1 month is 30 days and then 24 hours per day, so it will be 720 hours per month. Yeah, and the price per the hour is 825.7920. So the price will be just say 600,000 rupiah. I will use Google to convert it to US dollar. Yeah, it's priced about 41 US dollar per month. Yeah, or about 30% more expensive than Windows 365. Okay, let's go back to the VM creation. We continue to create the VM. I will fast forward this phase. Okay, the deployment is complete. Yeah, let's click go to resource. Okay, this is Windows 10 VM that we have created, and Azure will automatically start the VM. To connect with the VM we've just created, yeah, we use remote desktop app. And then we type the IP that we copy the IP and then we paste it and click connect. Enter the username and password that we entered previously. And check on the remember me. If you prompted about the certificate, just check on the don't ask me again and then click yes. As you see, the first screen was exactly like the one that we see after we complete setup Windows 10. Okay, just click on the accept. Let's open Microsoft Edge. Okay, just complete the setup for the Microsoft Edge. And then let's do a speed test. Okay, let's start do the speed test. I will choose the M1. As you see, the speed was kind of awesome, yeah. And for me who live in Indonesia, seeing this speed was like a dream. Okay, let's now install Microsoft Office to see the experience using a desktop. Okay, the Office installation is finished. Let's open some on Office document, yeah, so that we can know the desktop experience and the bandwidth usage for this desktop, yeah. Okay, let's open the Task Manager and then View, or no, Always on Top. Okay, let's focus on the internet speed, yeah. Just say I edit something here. Name was. Okay. As you see, if I do some light editing document, yeah, it only takes about less than 1 megabyte per second, even less than 100 kilobyte per second. How about we edit some a colorful office document? Just say we open the PowerPoint. Okay, focus on the scent, yeah. You see, even if I move the pixel a lot, yeah, if I move the presentation a lot, it only take less than 1 megabyte per second. See on the same one, it only take less than 1 megabyte per second. Okay, let's do another thing. How about we watch some YouTube channel? Let's see one of the video. Let's set it on the yes. As you see, the bandwidth usage is around 5 to 13 megabit per second. Okay, how about we see some other video that having a lot of frame per second? This one. Okay, let's skip the part where there is a lot of activity. As you see, the bandwidth usage is around 12 to 16 megabit per second. Yeah, even that with that speed, I don't get some very good experience like 60 frame per second video with this remote desktop. Okay, that's how we've set up Windows 10 on Azure VM. I was live in Jakarta metropolitan area and having like 30 to 40 megabit per second. And seeing that VM speed is kind of shocking to me. So what's the difference between Windows 10 VM and Windows 10 in Windows 365? The first one is about price structure. Both options offer their own price structure and benefit. As for today, the only Windows 365 offer that we know is the one that Windows 365 Business that price about $31 per user per month. With this option, you can get an accurate price and you can budget accurately. Windows 10 VM in Azure offer per hour price, even per second price. With this way, you can get a flexible cost per month. Yeah. And if you use it strictly in office hour, you can get a cheaper price than Windows 365. But don't forget, other than it's charged for the hourly price, it's also charged the usage of the bandwidth and the usage of the hard disk AO, which is not really significant unless you use it very intensively. The second one is about flexibility. Windows 365, so much like Microsoft 365. You will go with the package offered by Microsoft, and the upgrade option is limited. Also, there's no admin access to the VM. While Windows 10 VM is so much like you managing Azure, you will have a full control on and flexible upgrade to your VM, changing your hard drive, and so on. The third one is about manageability and managing experience. Windows 10 VM in Azure managing experience is so much like managing infrastructure. You create and manage it using Azure Control Panel, and the one that having access to it is only the subscription admin. Also, if you're targeting only to activate in office hour, yeah, you have to turn off and turn on in office hour. In summary, it's so much like managing hardware. In Windows 365, you manage it in Microsoft Admin Panel. The same admin panel with Microsoft 365. The experience is so much like managing license in Microsoft 365. We still only see video about Windows 365 today, but I believe it's so much like managing email server in Microsoft 365. It's easier than managing email server in VM in Azure. The fourth one is about resuming your desktop session. In Windows 365 announcement video, Microsoft offered that you will get the auto resume. Yeah, your desktop will be just as when you left it. Same thing actually offered by Windows 10 VM. Your desktop will be just the time when you left it, as long as you don't shut down or restart your VM. But if you're targeting cost saving by only turn on your VM in the office hour, obviously your desktop will be not the way you left it in the next working day. Okay, that's how to set up your Windows 10 VM in Azure. Yeah, and several difference between Windows 10 VM in Azure and Windows 365. That's it for today.